Shalom.
Shalom.
Yeah, this morning I'm going to talk about two different kinds of leadership. The first one is just like we read from the scripture is King Saul. And the next one is King David. There's two different kinds of leadership styles. One is self-righteousness, self-arrogant, and one is try to use people. Yeah, they just try to very proud of himself, and everything is on his head. So the topic I'm going to use is a biblical profile. What is the profile? I only know the profiles when I'm going to retire.
Yeah,
one of the financial counselors asked me, what is your financial profile? I say I have my personal IRA, I pay some tax to government. Oh, he said, okay, that's good, at least you have food to eat.
How
about your other's income? I say, yes, I put every year I put some money in the bank. Under my 401k. Then he suggested, he said, okay, how about you put your 50,000 in the Prudential life insurance? Then when you retire, they are going to give you every month around $200. Then I know that another word, annuity. Annuity, that's $200 every month. I give it back to you through you put the 50,000 in the bank in the Prudential life insurance.
當我將我的5萬放在保險裏面,於是我每年裏面每個月都能夠得到200元。
He say, you have to put it into over there 7 years, don't touch it. I guarantee you get $200 every month.
但是首先你要保證你放了錢在那裏的時候,你有7年不要碰它,你才能夠在每
I hope so. So what is the biblical profile? What is the leadership style? Oh, we can say, who is the leader of this church? Who are the leaders of this church? What is their requirement? What is their background? Why they can become a leader of this church? That is a biblical profile of the leaders from the Bible. Before I share the message from the God, I hope you can understand this sentence. We are human beings. We are not human doing.
我们就是人，但是呢，我们不是human doing。
There is a big difference of being and doing.
在英文里面，human being就是属人，而human doing就是说人去做紧嘢。
If you work at any company,
如果你是在某些公司里面工作,
we just expect you to do good.
公司就会期望你能够做得正确，做得好。
But if you want to serve at the church,
但当你在教会里面做侍奉,
it is not what you can do.
并不是说视乎你可以做些什么。
I believe it is who you are.
我是相信是视乎你是哪一个，是什么人。
You belong to whom?
你是属于哪一个？
What's your relationship with God?
你和神的关系是怎样？
What is the requirement? You know, God put it very clearly in the Bible.
在圣经里面有没有说清楚究竟人和神的关系是怎样？
That is a biblical profile.
这个就是圣经的案子了。
Now let's look at the Bible.
我们一起来看看圣经。
The first king of Israel, the Saul, King Saul.
是以色列里面第一个的王，就是以扫王。
In the beginning, he's very good.
在起手的时候，这个扫罗王是很好的。
He's handsome, he's tall guy, he must be something good.
他外貌和身材高大又俊美，应该是属于好的王。
Oh, what's wrong about him? What's wrong about the first king of Israel?
在以色列的这个第一个王。 到底有什么问题发生呢？
Finally, he put up himself in the most high place in the country.
首先，他就是建立这个王在最高的地方里面。
Then he became arrogant.
他就开始有不耐烦。He
became selfishness.
他变成很自私。
Then he became his leader of the country.
他变成这个国家的领导。
He can do anything.
他就可以做任何事。
Even those sacrifice sins belong to the priest.
即使是一些献祭，应该是属于祭司做嘅嘢，佢都做埋。
And he disobeyed God.
佢就对神系不顺从。
What's the end of his life?
到底佢最后嘅生命系点样呢？
God reject him.
神系拒绝咗佢。
God separate him from any other people.
神更加将这个扫罗王与其他的人分隔。
What kind of sins he did wrong?
到底扫罗王犯了什么罪呢？
So look at the 1 Samuel. Okay, 1 Samuel is behind the book of Judges.
我们一起来打开
1 Samuel chapter 15.
1
Samuel chapter 15.
打开撒母耳记上第15章。
When King Saul rebelling against God, and God sent Samuel, the prophet Samuel, the first one ordained him, and Samuel wanted to point it out. What's going wrong of the king's life?
1
Samuel chapter 15, verse 22.
我们看撒母耳记上第15章第22节。
Because the king Saul said, I did everything according to what you say. I did everything what God wanted me to do. I did everything good.
他说，我是按着神所讲的嘢去做的，我一切所做的都是做得啱的。
Then Samuel said, why I still hear the voice of the lamb? Why I still hear the voice of the ox and all the cattle's voice? Why? You have to kill totally, completely about the enemies of God.
扫罗就同撒母耳就对扫罗讲，佢话耶和华嘅燔祭，点解佢会能够听到一啲牛嘅声音同埋羊嘅声音呢？
Oh, he said, you know, we should keep these good things, the good sheep, the good rams, the good cattle, to dedicate it to your God, to sacrifice to your God. It's no problem. I keep it.
我话冇问题嘅，我预备呢啲嘅牛同埋羊系做要嚟做燔祭，要献俾神嘅。
Then Samuel said.
于是撒母耳记就讲啦，撒母耳就讲啦。Verse
22.
第22节。
Does the Lord delight in burnt offering and sacrifice as much as in obeying
the voice of the Lord?
撒母耳说：“耶和华喜悦燔祭和平安祭，岂如喜悦人听从他的话呢？”
To obey is better than sacrifice, and to heed is better than the fat of rams.
听命胜于献祭，顺从胜于公羊的油脂。
For rebellion, sin against God, rebellion is like the sin of divination, and arrogance, like the evil of idolatry.
活逆的罪与行邪术的罪相等，顽梗的罪与拜虚神和偶像的罪相同。
Because you have rejected the word of the Lord, you have rejected the God's comment, God's word, He has rejected you as a king of Israel.
你既厌弃耶和华的命令，耶和华也厌弃你作王。
Then the king Saul said to Samuel, I have sinned, I violated the Lord's command and your instruction. I was afraid of the people, and so I give in to them because you came too late. I wait for you. You came too late. That's why I sacrificed to God. I dedicated, I burned the offering. Now I beg you, Samuel, I beg you, forgive my sins and come back to me. Come back with me so that I may worship the Lord.
苏罗就对撒母耳话：你得太迟了，我不可以再等了，所以我就唯有将嗰个献祭先烧上嚟到作献祭。我有罪。 因为惧怕百姓听从他的话，就违背了耶和华的命令和你的言语。Verse 26.
But Samuel said to King, I will not go back with you. You have rejected the word of the Lord, and the Lord has rejected you as king over Israel.
撒母耳对扫罗说， 我不同你回去，因为你厌弃耶和华的命令，耶和华也厌弃你作以色列的王。Verse
27, as Samuel turned on to leave, Saul, the king Saul, caught hold of the edge of his robe, and it torn apart.
27节，撒母耳转身要走，扫罗就扯住他外袍的衣襟，衣襟就撕断了。
Then Samuel said to the king, The Lord has torn the kingdom of Israel from you today and has given it to another one, the one of your neighbor, that is the David, to one better than you.
撒母耳对王说：如此，你今日耶和华使以色列国与你断绝，将这国赐予比你更好的，那个就是大卫。
29. He who is the glory of Israel does not lie or change his mind, for he is not a man what he should change his mind.
29节，以色列的大能者必不自说谎，也不自后悔，因为他回非世人，绝不后悔。
Then we are 16, chapter 16, and we are going to say, who is David? Why God choose him?
接着就是在16章的时候，就是为什么神拣选了大卫作王呢？
Why God didn't choose and anointed the eldest son of Jesse, Eliab, but choose the youngest one, David? Why? What's the point?
为什么又说不选择耶西屋里面的长子？
以利甲而选择最小的儿子大卫呢？Here is the reason.
以下就是其中的原因了。Chapter 16.
Now the Lord said to prophet Samuel, How long were you sorry? How long were you mourn for Saul, King Saul? Since I have rejected him as a king over Israel? How long? How long you have to say sorry for him? The Lord said to Samuel, Chapter 16, verse 1. The Lord said to Samuel, How long were you mourn or sorry for Saul, King Saul? Since I have rejected him as the king over Israel, fill your home with oil, and be on the way. I am sending you to Jesse, to Jesse of Bethlehem. Bethlehem is the place where Jesus was born. Jesus is the inheritance, the descendants of King David. I am sending you to Jesse of Bethlehem. I have chosen one of his sons to be king, because Jesse has 8 boys.
第16章第1節，耶和華對撒母耳說：我既厭棄掃羅作以色列的王，你為他悲傷要到幾時呢？你將油高油勝滿了國，我差遣你往伯利恆人耶西那裡去，因為我在他眾兒子之內要選定一個作王，這個王就是大衛，而耶穌基督他就是大衛王的後裔。
But Samuel said, how can I go? King Saul will kill me. We're hearing about it and it will kill me.
第二節，撒母耳說：我怎能去呢？掃王若聽見，必要殺我。
Then the Lord said, you take a heifer with you and say, I have come to sacrifice to the Lord.
耶和華說：你可以帶一隻牛犊去，就說我來是要向耶和華獻祭。
Now you invite Jesse to the sacrifice, and I will show you what to do. You are to anoint it for me, the one I indicated to you.
你要請耶西來吃祭肉，我就指示你所當行的事，我所指給你的，你要告他。
Then Samuel did what the Lord said. When he arrived at Bethlehem, the elders of the city trembled. When they met Samuel, they say, do you come for peace? Do you come in peace?
當撒母耳就照住耶和華的話去行，到了伯利恆，那城裏的長老都戰戰兢兢地來到迎接他，就問：你是平安來的麼？
Then Samuel replied, yes, in peace. I have come to sacrifice to the Lord. Consecrate yourself, clean yourself, and come to the sacrifice with me. Then he consecrated Jesse and his 8 boys, and he invited them to the sacrifice.
他說：為平安來的，我是給耶和華獻祭，你們當自潔，來與我同吃祭肉。耶和華就使耶西和眾子自潔，請他來。
Now, verse 6, when they arrived, Samuel saw Eliab, the oldest son of Jesse, and he thought, surely the Lord's anointed hands, anointed one, stand here just before the Lord.
第6節，他們來的時候，撒母耳看見以利亞，就心裡說：耶和華的受膏者必定在他面前。
I believe Eliab is a handsome boy, is a handsome man, and also a lot of muscle and a huge guy.
我深信这个大仔以利亚一定是一个好俊美又好高大，一定是满有肌肉的一个人。
But the Lord said to Samuel, "Do not consider his appearance or his height, for I have rejected him. The Lord does not look at the outward appearance." But the Lord looks at the heart.
第7節，耶和華對撒母耳說：不要看他的外貌和身材高大，我不揀選他，因為耶和華不像人看人，人是看外貌，耶和華是看內心。
Then Jesse said, I have a second one. He called Abinadab the second son and had him pass in front of Samuel. But Samuel said, the Lord has not chosen this one either.
第8節，耶西叫阿比拿 拿達，他另外一個兒子從撒母耳面前經過，撒母耳話：耶和華不揀選他。
Then the third one, the third son, the Shammah. Jesus then had Shammah pass by, but Samuel say, No, has the Lord choose this one?
9節，耶西又叫第三個兒子撒瑪從撒母耳面前經過，撒母耳說：耶和華不揀選他。
Verse 10, and Jesse had 7 boys of his son passed by before Samuel, but Samuel said to him, The Lord has not chosen these.
10節，耶西叫他7個兒子都從撒母耳面前經過，撒母耳說：這都不是耶和華所揀選的。
So then Samuel say, ask Jesse, Do you have another one?
撒母耳就對耶西講：你嘅兒子仲會唔會有其他呢？
Are these all your boys?
呢度係咪所有係你嘅
And Jesse said, you know, I still have the youngest one. There is still my youngest one. He is working outside in the open field to take care of my sheep. And Jesse answered, but he's tending the sheep. But Samuel said, same for him. We will not sit down and eat until he comes.
撒母耳对耶西说：你的儿子都在这里么？他回答说：还有一个小的，现在就放羊。撒母耳对耶西说：你打发人去叫他来，若他不来，我们必不坐席。
So Jesse sent and had him brought David in. He was ruddy, he was in red skin, he was a fine appearance, he's a handsome boy, a handsome feature.
耶西就打发人去叫他来，他面色光红，双目清秀，容貌俊美。耶和华说，这就是。
Yes, then the Lord said, rise, get up, stand up, anointed him. He is the one, he is the king, the next king of Israel.
耶和华就说，这个就是他了，这个就是以色列的下一个王，起来高他。
So Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the presence of his seven brothers.
13节，撒母耳就用各类嘅膏油，在他诸兄各兄弟当中就将。
And from that day on, the Holy Spirit of the Lord came upon David in power. Samuel and went back home.
从嗰日起，耶和华嘅灵就大大咁感动大卫，而撒母耳就开始起身回去拉马。
So who is David?
究竟边一个叫做系以利亚呢？
What kind of requirement God emphasized?
究竟耶和华所强调嘅系乜嘢呢？
The Lord said to Samuel, "Do not consider his appearance, his outside appearance, or his height, for I have rejected him." Then the Lord does not look at the things the people look at. We look at people from outside, but God say, "I am look at his heart." The heart of David, that is the difference.
而耶和华所看重嘅，并唔系一般人所看嘅。喺第七节里面话，耶和华对撒母耳说：不要看他的外貌和身材高大，我不拣选他，因为耶和华不像人看人，人系向住佢嘅外貌，而耶和华系看住佢哋嘅内心。
So who is King David?
到底边一个系大卫王呢？
Now you have to look at the book of Acts chapter 13, then you understand who is David.
如果我哋要睇呢个《使徒行传》第十三章，我哋就会去认识多啲关于呢个大卫王。
Then the people ask for a king, and he give them King Saul, son of Kissi, of the tribe of Benjamin, who ruled the Israel 40 years.
而呢一个扫罗就系。
And verse 22. After removing King Saul, he made David their king. So God testified concerning David. I have found David, the son of Jesse, a man after my own heart. That's the difference. David's a person, his heart, after God's heart. Not only that, he will do everything I want him to do. He do everything according to the will of God.
而我所揀選，而神就話：佢所揀選大衛，就係因為大衛佢係按住神嘅命令嚟到去做，所以佢要揀選大衛。He
is a man seek after God's heart.
佢係一個係能夠追尋神嘅心意嘅人。
He want to carry out God's heart, God's idea, not his own agenda.
佢願意去追求神嘅旨意，但係唔追求佢自己個人旨意嘅人。
Why choose King David?
點解要選擇大衛王？
What's the difference between King Saul and King David?
到底掃羅王同埋大衛王嘅分別喺邊度？
There's a big difference.
呢個係其實有好大嘅分別。
Acts chapter 13, verses 34 to 37, you know, Paul mentioned about the Jesus. But he say, Jesus comes from the family of King David.
而呢個《使徒行傳》十三章廿三十四節三十七節就係講而呢個大衛王，而耶穌就係從一個大衛王嘅祖宗嚟嘅族譜裏面嚟嘅。So
then Paul said, God raised him, God raised the Son of God, Jesus Christ, from the dead, so that he will never be subject to decay. As God has said, I will give you the holy and sure blessings promised to David.
而保罗就是说，神的儿子就是从大卫的祖宗而来的，而他能够让他的儿子能够不会老坏，能够在水里复活的。Okay,
this is not David, that's why verse 35 says, so it is also stated some other place, you will not let your Holy One be decayed.
在《使徒行传》第35节就是说，论到神叫他从死里复活，不再归于老为，这就说若说，我必将所应许大卫那圣洁可靠的恩典赐给你们。So
who is David?
到底大卫是谁呢?
Now, when David had served God's purpose in his own generation, according to God's plan, according to God's purpose to serve the people, that is the different.
而神所拣选的就是他们是用心的去能够侍奉神的子民。
And finally, he fell asleep. He died.
而最后他就是睡了,
and he was buried.
最后就,
just like his parents, like his ancestors. And King David's body decayed, he died. But Jesus Christ, but the one whom God raised from the dead, did not see decay. So you see, there's two different kind of biblical profile about the leaders.
而这里就可以看到从圣经里面的各案子的不同。
So what about the Old Testament to say the God's leader? How God choose leader?
在旧约里面，神是怎样去选择这些领导人呢？
And the first one, Moses choose a leader to help him to serve the people, at least half a million people.
就是拣选的以色列的领导呢，就是来到去侍奉数万人的百姓。Okay,
let's look at the Exodus, the second book, Exodus chapter 18, verse 21 to 23. Exodus.
我哋一齐打开出埃及记。
Chapter 18. Who are the leader? What's the qualify? What is the qualification? What is the requirement about the leaders?
究竟一個領導人，他又需要什麼的要求？他的質素應該是怎樣呢？
Who are they in Moses' time? Acts chapter 18, verse 21.
在出埃及記，Exodus. 在出埃及記第18章,
verse 21 to 24. Listen carefully, in the Old Testament, how God chose leaders.
小心聆听，我哋认识下喺旧约里面神系点样拣选呢个领导人。Who
are they?
嗰啲领导人系边啲咧？
What is their background?
佢哋嘅背景系点样？
What the requirement God wants?
究竟神所要求佢哋嘅要求系点样？
So God say to Moses.
所以神就对摩西话：
You select a capable person, capable man from all the people. Men who feel God, God's feeling, trustworthy persons who hate dishonest gain.
神就对摩西说，你要在百姓里面选择有才能的人，就要是敬畏神、诚实无妄、恨不义之财的人。
Then you appoint them as officers over the thousands, hundreds, fifties, and tens.
於是乎，你就能夠選擇嗰啲嘅人，派佢作為千夫長、百夫長、五十夫長、十夫長。
Now you have them serve to judge as a judge for the people at all the times, but they have bring the very difficult case before you, Moses. But those judge, those leaders can solve the simple case.
百夫長就嚟到去管理百姓，就叫佢哋能夠隨時去審判百姓。大事嘅都要呈到去摩西面前，小事嘅就由佢哋自己可以審判咁樣。Because
they share the responsibility with you, Moses.
因為嗰啲人就能夠將摩西嘅責任能夠 分散开.
Then God said to Moses, if you do this, if you do this and follow my command, God's command, you will be able to stand the strain. You have the power, you have the strength, and all these people will go home satisfied. Satisfy you as their leader.
如果摩西能够这样做的时候，神也这样吩咐你，你就能够得，你就能够受得住，这百姓也能够平平安安地回到家里面。
But who knows, after several centuries, there's another Saul, and God changed his name, Apostle Paul. And in the New Testament, God said to him, you need to choose the leaders in the church, every local church.
经过几百年之后，亦都有一啲嘅领导又，譬如就系保罗，使徒保罗，佢亦都系再重新嘅面对呢个挑选一啲领导人喺呢个教会里面。
And there's some requirement, there's some background, there's some of the qualification you have to keep.
而呢啲嘅喺教会里面所选择嘅领导人，亦都系有啲唔同嘅要求。
Very important. The first one is blameless.
系非常之重要噶，而首要嘅就系要无可指责。
Paul said, who is the elder of this church?
保罗就说,究竟哪一个是教会里面的长老呢?
Who is the overseers?
哪一个是属于能够做监督的呢?
Who is the superintendent? Who is the bishop of this church?
究竟哪一个是做监督,哪一个是这个教会的...
leader.
教会的领导呢?
First one.
首先第一点,
first requirement.
第一个的要求是,
blameless.
无可指责.
People will not put him or her into the jail.
人能够将这个人，将被选嘅呢一个嘅领导。
You cannot find anything wrong from him.
你唔能够会喺佢身上揾得出揾出一啲嘅指责嘅地方。
Now you have the characters of God's servant.
所以呢一种嘅领导，佢能够有神嘅样式去能够侍奉。
Number two.
第二点.
Don't overwork it. Don't overbear it.
系唔能够。 不能任性.
Number three.
第三点.
Don't arrogant.
不暴躁.
Number four.
第四点.
Don't self-will. Don't just serve yourself.
是不任性.
Selfish.
不自私.
And don't have a quick temper, hot temper or quick temper.
不会有性情暴躁.
That's why the book of James chapter 1 says, my dear friend, my dear brothers, understand this. Everyone must be quick to listen, slow to speak, slow to anger. If you want the leader of this church, quick to listen, slow to speak, slow to anger. You control your temper.
所以就在雅各书里面就提及到作为领导的 或者是作为信徒的，你们不能够性情暴躁，你们要慢慢的发怒，要仔细的快快的听，慢慢的发怒。
Don't give